It's just the right size for the boy to cuddle. The boy hugged the rabbit close and gave him a kiss on his soft, velvety nose. The boy stayed in the playroom with the rabbit all day. He didn't play with any of his other toys. Soon it was dinner time, and the boy had to leave his rabbit. Once he was gone, the other toys talked to the rabbit. A shiny robot asked, "What can you do?" "I don't know," replied the rabbit. "Well, I can walk back and forth," said the robot. "And someday I'm going to be a real, are you?" The rabbit turned to Old Horse. He was the oldest and wisest toy in the playroom. "What's real?" asked Rabbit. Old Horse smiled. "Real is when a child loves you very, very much for a long, long time," he replied. "It's when he loves you so much that your shiny coat grows dull and you don't look so new anymore." "Oh my," explained Rabbit. "When you are real, you don't care how you look because there is nothing better than being loved," said Old Horse. Just then the boy came into the playroom. He left.
Hair back, hair up onto her head. Here is your new style,
to Grasshopper, but Bridget didn't say anything. She just sat very still in her chair. "Is it what you wanted?" asked Lucy. Bridget stared down at her sneakers. "Well, not exactly," she mumbled. "Let's try something else," said Lucy. She combed, teased, and sprayed Bridget's hair, then handed Bridget a mirror. "Lovely," said Christian Crickets. "Beautiful," said Bridget's mother. But again, Bridget didn't say anything. "This isn't what you wanted either, is it?" asked Lucy. Lucy nodded. Hair at Lucy's